Alrighty, we're here for a cube draft. Have an interesting booster pack here with Inferno Titan's great, Garrick Relentless is really good, Tropical Island is excellent, Top is so-so, Tidings is awesome. Here, for me, it's a choice between Tidings, Tropical Island, and Garrick Relentless. Planeswalkers are ridiculously powerful. I usually value them the highest. But dual lands are quite good, and Tidings is great too. Think I'm just gonna go with the Garrick here. Green and blue are my favorite colors in the cube, and Garrick is the cheapest between it and Tidings, and it is kind of the most flexible. Easy to splash, so I'm gonna take the Garrick Relentless. Well, in for a penny, in for a pound, right? I mean, probably taking another Garrick here. I like Planeswalkers a lot. There's not a super good blue card in the pack. I mean, Ravages of War is also quite good, but I think I'm just gonna go Garricking. What do we have here? Options. Volcanic Island, Rancor, Cloud Goat Ranger, Flame Tongue Kavu. Pretty bad options. Don't want to go green-white. I mean, Cloud Goat Ranger's kind of eh. Wicker Bow Elder's alright as well, but probably Troll Ascetic or Volcanic Island here. Given the fact that my Garrick is triple green, I think it's going to be important to go heavy base green. I think I'm going to go with the Troll Ascetic here and just go all in. I'm just going to take every green card I see and hope it works out. Court of Calling is fine, but Breeding Pool is like excellent. Am I more likely to play green, blue, or green, red? Taiga is here as well. I mean, I did pass a Tropical Island, which stinks for me. Could just take the Taiga and hope, like, the Curd Ape wheels and have, like, some mediocre red-green beatdown deck. I'm just gonna take the Breeding Pool here. Blue is so much better than red. Survival of the Fittest. That's a pretty clear, signally build-around card. Hard to justify not taking it, really. So I'll take it. Would be nice to get opposition. That would be a good reason to go blue with green. This Troll Ascetic is pretty bad. Hope to not play it, but yeah, it could end up working out. Pretty bad pack here. Thoughtseize is alright, not great, but I really don't have a good reason to want to be black right now. I think for me, the pick is just Rootbound Crag. I could end up going red-green, and I'm really not missing out on much. I mean, Thawing Glaciers is not particularly good in a green deck. And Molten Tail Massacre is just like a really weak card. Ooh. Think I'm going to take Shardless Agent here, just because it's so cool. It's giving me a good reason to use my Breeding Pool, and if that was not in the pack, Thornscape Battlemage is so-so, Indrix Stompholler is very good, but kind of a dime a dozen. I mean, you could just get, like, Wicker Bow Elder or Trigon Predator or whatever, but a Shardless Agent is a very unique effect that is very powerful. Here, nothing good really. Bolrath Stronghold could be really good, as could Lodestone Golem. I think I'm going to take the Lodestone Golem on the off chance that I just get a large amount of green one mana acceleration, because just playing that thing on turn 3 or whatever is really strong. I mean, not the best pickup, but a good card. Well, could take Savage Lands or Putrefy, but I really like Tidings and I wanted to first pick it, so boom. Tidings is also quite nice if you get like Noble Hierarch, Llanowar Elves type stuff, because if you just go like turn one Elf, turn two Elf, turn three Tidings, it really leads to some explosive hands. I mean, granted, I'd rather have a Garrick there, but. Interesting. Don't think I can really justify passing Ravages of War because it's ridiculously powerful. So I'll take it. Hopefully, I can splash it. And Clogger Ranger, really? Yeah, that card is really, really powerful. Maybe I should try to go Bant or just green white. Here, I like Isolated Chapel. Could end up just going green white. I need more cards that cost 1 and 2 mana so I don't get run over. A fine last pick. Oh! Lotus Cobra, Karn, Collation Relic. All really high power cards. Collation Relic or Karn? They're both ridiculously good. I'm just gonna go with the Karn here. I mean, I have a Planeswalker theme going, and I don't wanna. I mean, Karn is just ridiculous. It's the most fun card in the pack. It'll be the most fun card for you guys to watch, that's for sure. So, Karn it is. Also, it's probably top five best cards in the cube, just overall best, because it's so good. Alrighty, we have a lot of options here. Wyrmcoil Engine, Nature's Lore, and I mean, I could take Ralzerec, but I don't want to. I think I'm just gonna go with Nature's Lore here. I have such good late game, I can't really scoff at a Rampant Growth. And it does get my breeding pool, which is nice. Yeah, Nature's Lore it is. Here we have Birthing Pod, Gilded Lotus, Manowar. Kind of just want the Gilded Lotus. Doesn't do a whole lot for me though. Yep, I'll just take Gilded Lotus. I mean, there's really nothing else in this pack. Balance is pretty good. Otherwise, it's Kaiga or Engineered Explosives or Scalding Tarn. I think I'm just gonna go with Balance here. I mean, I would love a Scalding Tarn, but Balance is pretty nice. Obsidat, Marsh Flats. Awful pack. I'm just gonna take a Marsh Flats, I think. Yep, I will. Tinker, which I don't like. Or like. I guess Red Elemental Blast for the sideboard is reasonable. Really awful pack right there. Ooh, Factor Fiction. Yep, gonna take Fact or Fiction here. Is it psychotic that I really want to build a deck in which the only card Shardless Agent can hit is balance? So I just play, like, nothing that's cheap at all, and then I just try to get by like that. I mean, definitely not gonna play this or that. So 11 playables, pretty good. I mean, I have to play Nature's Lore. It's too good not to play. But yeah, we're in an interesting position here. Gonna take Mind Stone here. Too hard to justify passing it, and it's so good with so many of the things I have, so Mind Stone it is. Mana Fixing is not very good. Spells are not very good. And losing. Don't have a lot of playables either. I mean, that's not true. I have two Garrix, Karn, Factor Fiction, Ravages of War, Tidings, Gilded Lotus, Balance. I have really good cards, but this is not quite a full deck just yet. Acidic Slime, Gifts Ungiven. I like Acidic Slime here. Pretty good card. Wake Thrasher or Parallax Wave. I like Wake Thrasher quite a lot, actually. Well, black and red cards that I refuse to play, and a misdirection. Highly unlikely I'll ever board in misdirection, but that's nice to have the option. Here I'm going to go with a Baleful Strix. These other cards don't really do anything that I like, and I'm not going to play Lion's Eye Diamond, that's for sure.